And I just felt God just moving in here, and he's here. Amen. And I just bless his name and for the things that who he is, everything that who he is. God is awesome. God is mighty. Amen. And we're going to be working on that. We'll work on those speakers and get it the way that it should be. Amen. But listen, I want you to get your Bibles, and I want to talk to you a little bit. And I can see, you know, sometimes I say, God, why do you give me, you know, such things and such messages? And I want you to go with me to 2 Samuel. If I take a topic today, I would say it's time for you to come out of Lodabar.
Come on.
Or in a subtopic, and I will say that's a seat for you at the king's table. Say, woo, God, help me to get through this one. Hallelujah. I want you to get your Bibles and go with me in the book of 2 Samuel, and we're going to go to the 9th chapter. And if you have it, if you feel like standing, you got legs to stand, you feel like that you can get with that, just go with me to 2 Samuel, the 9th chapter. Amen. 2 Samuel, the 9th chapter. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Pastor, just turn me down a little bit from the gain. I was trying to find the side of the speaker that's cut it down, but look like it's just got me going through here. Amen. How many of you know the devil is mad?
Yes.
Woo! Hallelujah. He's mad, and I am glad that Jesus is Lord. Somebody better say amen. And if I would tell you today, it's time to stop living in Lodabar. That's what I want to talk about. Go with me to 2 Samuel, the 9th chapter. Amen, the 9th chapter, beginning with the first verse. Read, let's read in concert. And David said, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? Read on.
And there was of the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba.
Uh-huh.
And when they had called him unto David, the king said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he said, thy servant is
here. Come on. Now Ziba was of the house of Saul. And he said, or thou Ziba, or you can say Ziba, a Ziba. Amen. And he said, thou servant is he. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, he said, Jonathan had yet a son, which is lame on his feet. And the king said unto him, where is he? Read with me. And Ziba said
unto the king, behold, he is in the house of
Mashur, the son of Imriel, in Lodabar. Read on.
The king David said, and fetched him from the house of Mashur,
the son of Imriel, from Lodabar. Now hold on to that scripture. Bow your heads with me. Father God, I thank you for all things in the name of Jesus. I bless your name today. I praise you for who you are, God, and I thank you for your word. God, your word is true. Your word is holy. Your word is phenomenal, God, and I thank you for the word of God today. And I ask you to give us ears to hear, eyes to see, God, that we may receive this word on good ground that it can bring forth 100-fold. And we bless your name right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Now go with me to 2 Samuel. Y'all can write that scripture down and go with me to 2 Samuel 4, the 4th chapter. And I want you to know that David looking for somebody of the household of Saul. He looking for somebody that he can show kindness to.
Yes.
And if you know, y'all know about King Saul and King David. You know how Saul hated David because of what? He was anointed. And God had chosen him to be the next in line to be king. Can you say amen? Anybody hating on you because you're anointed and the power of God is in your life? Come on, somebody. Somebody better say amen. Anybody jealous of you or how God used you under the power and the anointing of God? Anybody look at you and say, you a woman, you're supposed to be acting like that? You're supposed to be used like that? But see, it's the he on the inside of me is the one that's in charge. Somebody better, hey! He said, neither male nor female. Somebody better say amen. It by the spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Not by might or by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Somebody better say amen. Get 2 Samuel 4:4.
Amen.
Let's read together. And y'all got it?
Uh-huh.
Let's read. And Jonathan, Saul's son,
had a son that was laying on his feet.
Uh-huh. Listen, everybody, listen up. He was 5 years old when the tiding came of Saul and Jonathan out of Jezreel. And his nurse took him up and fled. And it came to pass as she made haste to flee. Read.
And he fell and became lame. And his name was
Mephibosheth. Mephibosheth was the son of Saul. You may be seated. Now listen, many people live in a state of loneliness. People who have been so many things that happened to them, and so many things that they came up with. But listen, Mephibosheth was 5 years old when this tragedy happened to him. Can you say amen?
Amen.
There are things in our lives that have happened to us when we may have been 3 years old, 2 years old, 4 years old, 5, 6, 7. Things that really traumatize us. Come on, somebody. That caused us to live in Lodabar. Lodabar was on the outskirts. And now listen, was the outskirts of Gilead. Gilead was where the healing balm was. But it was a part of Gilead, or Mahanaim, that Lodabar was right here. Let me tell you, all the ones that live in Lodabar was those that were lonely, those that were depressed, those that were rejected by man, those that were outcast, those that was abused. Come on, somebody. They found a safe haven to live right there so they don't have to be bothered with nobody. These people that lives in Lodabar, some of them are introverted people. People that love to be secluded, love to stay by themselves, love to not to come around a lot of people. You need to understand. Come on, somebody. when Saul and Jonathan got out there and began to fight with the Philistine, they lost the battle. Why? Because they didn't have, amen, come on, didn't have God to hear that voice, to know what they need to do. Come on, somebody. Saul couldn't hear God no more because he backslid. Come on, somebody. And then he went and wanted to go to a witch, an Endor. And that's like a lot of us. Some of you on the psychic line trying to find out, come on, Lord, what's going to happen to me? Some of you call the psychic and give them information. Do you know what I'm going to do this or what I'm going to do that? What's going to happen to me? I'm going to this. You going to the wrong source for an answer. Somebody better say amen. How many of you know if you need an answer today, there is a source you can go to, and his name is Jesus. Somebody better say amen. Hallelujah. Many people live in a state of loneliness. People who, I mean, every day, amen, they are in trouble out of the mainstream of society. I got to read this. And then in the activity of friendship outside of themselves, there are many who live right in the middle of our lives that we don't know that has been dislocated, has been misunderstood, amen, both by people and by the church. Somebody better say amen. They see you going through something, and then the church will say, I don't want to have nothing to do with you. That's not God. Come on, somebody. Causing people to live in Lullaby. Lullaby was such a place. The very meaning is not having a no pastor that was there. I'm not talking about me as a pastor. A pastor, when God said, I will lead you in green pastures. Somebody better say amen. You can't eat of the word of God when you're living in Lullaby. You're feeling sorry for yourself. Somebody better say amen. And you say it to yourself, but I want to let you know it's not your fault. Some of you that been molested, amen, as children, been raped, amen, amen, been ostracized, amen, by family member. All of these different things were not your fault. And it causes us to go into a place of depression. It causes us to feel sorry for ourselves. It causes us to be rejected. Don't want to be bothered with people or bothered with society. You are living in Lullaby. Somebody better say amen. You are living in Lullaby. You are unskilled, uneducated. Don't need to get your thing together. You don't know how, because you're living in Lullaby. But Mephibosheth felt sorry for himself. He said, He said, they was trying to kill me. I'm afraid. They killed my father. They killed my grandfather. So they took him and they led him to Lullaby. And that's where he stayed. That's where he lived. Lame from his feet. Lame. Don't you know the devil had put things in our lives that has crippled us from being more like God? Crippled us from going forward in Jesus. Can you say amen? Whether it's disobedience, whether it's shame, somebody better, what you did back then, God said, I will throw it in the sea of unforgiveness. Somebody better say amen. Stop living in yourself. Come on, somebody. Okay, nobody, ain't nobody gonna love me. Ain't nobody gonna do this. Ain't nobody gonna do that. And Charity, where did this girl go?
It was a guy.
A guy. Amen.
It's a girl.
I just want to know. Oh yeah, because God, man, that's, you talk about some, oh my God. Woo, Jesus. That's all right. Let there get out. Oh my God. Let me tell you something. The anointing of God will break every yoke. Let me tell you. Let that the devil recognize who you are in God. Somebody better say amen. That's not a devil in hell that I'm afraid of. Somebody better say yes. Something a little closer. Living in Lullabar, everything that happened to you that wasn't pleasant, somebody better say amen. Lullabar, those who live, amen, when statistics say, well, you're not going to make it because you don't have an education. Or statistic would say, well, you're just only going to go this far. All because you didn't go about the means the way man says for you to go. Can you say amen? Amen. Lullabar is the lowest place in your life you can go. Begging and searching for love. Begging and searching for somebody to take care of you. Somebody to love you. Somebody better say amen. Amen. When Jesus said, I love you, somebody better say amen. Amen. Lullabar would cause those people that live in Lullabar to stay comfortable right there. Yes. Right there. Right. They don't want to move no further, no higher. Well, I'm going to stay right here till I die. I'm going to stay on this way until I do this and do that. Somebody better say amen. Mephibosheth lived in Lullabar. He was the grandson of a king. Somebody better say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. How many know that by the good deeds that our parents have done, by the good deeds that our grandmother and our mothers and our father have done, God can show us favor. Amen. Can you say that? Favor. Hallelujah. The inhabitants of Lullabar, it wasn't their fault. They didn't have guidance for somebody to show them and to tell them, look, you can't, don't do this, watch out for that. They didn't know. But all of these things that in the back of our mind and in our hearts and in our soul, that we are saying, you know what? I can't make it. I just can't do. I've been tarnished. I don't made a mess of everything that happened to me in my life. I've been on drugs. Oh God, these are all the ones that live in Lullabar. They drink their troubles away and say, you know what? If I drink a fifth of liquor, I'll be all right. But when you sober up, your problem is still there. Let you know about a problem solver. His name is Jesus. If you got a problem, he can solve it for you. Somebody better say amen. Amen. Lord, I'm looking at these people, Lord Jesus. It wasn't Mephibosheth's fault that what happened to him. He was at the right place, but at the wrong time. So many of us be the same way. Be at the right place at the wrong time. Some of them will be at the wrong place at the wrong time. Somebody better say amen. Oh, some of you got to stop living in Lullabar. Stop trying to blame others on your problem. The problem lies in you. Somebody better say amen. But I'm here to tell you that there is a place. Glory to God at the king's table. But let me tell you, all of the outcasts that lives in Lullabar, what Jesus said, he said, I'm going to go and gather up all of the outcasts. Somebody better say amen. Glory to God. If you want Jesus, hallelujah, he's the one that died for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you say amen? Amen. God. People that live in Lola Bar and people that live up on the top, they don't want to associate themselves with those type of people. Can you say amen? An example of that is where the Good Samaritan. Come on. Amen. The Samaritan passed by a man that was beaten up and thrown on the side of the street. On the road. The Bible tell you that the Lord you came by, look at him. Oh, John don't fail over that ditch. You know, we don't know what all we say and how we say things. Somebody better say amen. The priest passed by, looked at him. They ought to be ashamed of himself. Didn't even help this man. But a Samaritan, the Bible says, a good Samaritan came by and saw the man over there. Got him, poured oil and wine in his wound, took him to an inn and said, can you take care of this man? When I come back, I'll pay you all that's due to you. Can we as Christians start looking out for our neighbors and our friends, asking to see who we can help to get out of Lola Bar by asking them to come to church, asking them to say, come on and go to church with me this morning? God is moving by his spirit. Those that lived in Lola Bar trying to make ends meet, trying to deal with the tragedies and the oppression, the things that they have went through in their lives, and trying to say, you know what, I'm going to be all right. I know God going to help me. And you still standing right there. Let us be reminded. Every thought that lifted itself up, amen, before God, God said, cast it out. Put down those strongholds in your life. The strongholds that want to keep you down, keep you depressed, keep you unhappy. Somebody better say amen. But I heard what scripture said. The joy of the Lord is my strength. When you need strength from God, God said, I get to tell you, all you got to do is to praise me. All you got to do is to bless me. Hallelujah. He is the one that can bring you out of Lola Bar. The Good Samaritan in St. Luke 10:33 took care of that man and took care of him until he got over his wound. This man had compassion and he had love. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Matthew 22:1 tells you about the outcast. Amen. Somebody get Matthew 22:1 with me. Matthew 22:1. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People, God is good. Amen. I said, God is good. Living in Lola Bar, children, sometimes you have to take care of your parents instead of your parents taking care of you. Amen. Sometimes you have to step up to the plate and say, you know what? I'm going to help my dad. I'm going to help my mom.
Exactly.
And that's living in Lola Bar. Can you understand? Lola Bar means that you think less of yourself. You just don't. You have a low self-esteem of yourself. Matthew 22:1. Let's read that, how Jesus is getting the outcast and bringing them into the house of the Lord. Let me tell you, it's not when they had a wedding. The wedding, that the Bible signified that how the kingdom of God is. And let's read that. I want you to read that with me. Amen. Amen. Y'all got it?
Amen.
Amen. Start reading. 22:1. Just start reading.
And Jesus answered and spake unto them again.
And a parable and said, the kingdom of heaven is what? Like unto a certain what? King. David was a king. Saul was a king, which made a marriage for his what? Son. Now notice this parable is like the kingdom of heaven is like. Okay, read on. Send forth his servant. Let's all read at the same time. To call them that was what? Bidden or invited to the wedding. And they would not what? Don't that sound like a lot of us? You invite them to come to church. I ain't coming to church. I ain't doing that. Amen. I'm not coming. I don't want to come. I'm going to come 3 months down the line later on. Soon as they get in trouble, they want to run to the house of God. Amen. The Bible said, fret not to assemble yourselves together amongst a believer in the house of God. This is where you meet. This is your meeting place. Come on. This is where you dine at the King's table. Somebody better say amen. Amen. Read on. A kill. All things are ready. Come unto the marriage and everything I have made provision for you. Come and eat. You got the invitation. Come on, somebody. God giving us invitation to come to him. Somebody better say amen. Amen. They that was bidden to the wedding, amen, they did not want to come. Another scripture said they had all kinds of excuses. It was a reason that they didn't want to come. Amen. Read on.
And went their ways. One of
see, listen at where they going. I'm going to my business. I'm going home. I'm not gone. I'm not doing this. We put everything that we want to put before God. Let me tell you, that's not going to work with him. Amen. And read. And the remnant took his servant and what? Spitefully and slew them. Read on.
But when the king heard thereof, he was wroth, and he sent forth his army.
That's what he did. Destroyed those what? Murderers. And burned up their city because he was upset. Oh, it won't be water but fire next time. Come on. Then said he to his servants, the wedding is ready.
But they which are bidden were not worthy.
Not even worthy to come. And listen at what he said. Go ye what? Therefore.
Into the house. And as many as ye shall find. Bid to the man.
So those servants went out. Read that 10th verse.
And those servants went out into the house. And gathered together all as many as they found. But were bad.
See that? That's how God wants to see people to come to his house to worship him in spirit and in truth. The thing is that I want to know and let people know that you that are living with these tragedies and things that happen to you, I want to make sure that you know that it's not your fault. God is saying to you, you didn't have anything to do with that. What happened to you? What happened that took place in your life that was unpleasant? He's saying to you, it's time to get out of Lodabar and come and sit at the king's table and dine and eat sufficiently. Somebody better say amen.
Amen.
God had made a way for us to escape out of the hands of the enemy, and he's making a way for you how to get out of Lodabar. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Fighting depression, suicide, drugs, alcohol, all these things that plays a psychological, amen, that plays upon you psychologically to prohibit you from getting to the place of God where you want to go. That's up here.
Amen.
That's right up here.
Amen.
And that's where the devil fight you at here. The battleground is here. Amen. Verbal abuse, that is right here. The reason they say verbal abuse And the reason they say things to you negatively and ugly, they want to get you right here. The reason they speak down to you, they want to get you here. But the Bible said, be ye transformed. Say it, my God, by the renewing of your mind. Don't care what the devil in hell say. Renew your mind every day by the word of God. These are people that do these things. They living in Lodabar themselves. They living in Lodabar themselves. But God said it's time for you to stop living in Lodabar and come out and eat at the King's table. Amen. So you can dine sufficiently. Somebody better say amen. Jesus saw when you went through the things that you went through. He loved us when we didn't even love ourselves. When we was weak and down and out, Jesus came and died on the cross for you to save you. Somebody better say amen. He died on that cross for you and for me. Can you say amen? Amen. Let me go back to Matthew right now. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Excuse me. To back to 2 Samuel. Go to 2 Samuel. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People, let me tell you. Get out of living in Lodabar. Yes. Refuse. I don't care what happened to you in your life. Somebody put you down. Somebody stopped loving you. You went through a hard time. You went through trials and tribulations. Somebody rejected you. Somebody walked away from you. Somebody lied on you. Somebody did everything that they could to you to keep you down. But I'm telling you, get out of Lodabar. Can you say amen? Get out of Lodabar. And what I was telling you about Lodabar was on the outskirts of Gilead. Gilead, where the healing bomb was. Do you know that when David said, is there a bomb, B-A-L-M, in Gilead? Which means that there was healing and deliverance right there in Gilead. Mephibosheth, you could have crawled over there to Gilead. Somebody better say amen. You got to walk out of your trouble, crawl out of your tragedy, crawl out of your depression, and go to the key table. That's what you have to do. What is crippling you from going forward and God and being in God what he wants you to be? It's time to get out of Lodabar. Amen. Listen at this. Amen. Amen. Amen, lovely. And the king said unto